Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. This week, we are going to introduce part two of our dashboard series. In this session, I would like to cover displaying a geographical map of different geographical locations, giving a really cool visual to the end user. So first, I would like to show you what our dashboard is going to look like in the end. Last time we worked with this dashboard, we put in the total units sold, the total sales, the total profit, the top salesperson, and the best sales day. I just rearranged those images to be on the right side of the screen right here. But what I would like to do today is I would like to first be able to display this map that you're seeing here, and then also be able to display this slicer over here where I can get information about my map for each region in detail. So how did I create this map? Let's look at the tab that generates this data set. I'm going to click on All Sales Final. When I'm looking at my data, once again, I have a date of sales, a salesperson, a state, the amount sold, the dollars earned, the cost, and the profit. But right now, I am concerned with this column right here, column D, the state. So the first thing I want to do is highlight column D, and I want to click on data and look at what is in this box of data types. So the type that I would like to select here is geography. Once I select that, watch how the cells change. I now have in my state column this icon right in front of each state that lets me know that this data type is now a geography data type. So I'm going to go over to the pivot table that I had created in our last video. I'm going to right click and hit refresh. As you can see, the name of the state is now spelled out. So I have now collected my total profit by state, and I am going to now create a map on my dashboard for that. So to insert my map, I now want to go back to the dashboard, and I'm going to go up to the menu here and go to Insert, click Maps, and go to Filled Map. Next, I want to right click on my map and go to Select Data. I'm going to select this up arrow over here and go to my Sales Final tab. First, I'm going to select my data in column D, hold down the Control key, and then select my data in column H, because I want to do this map by profit. Then I'm going to click this square up here and click OK. As you can see, it has now inserted a map into my dashboard. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Next, I would like to be able to create something that is called a slicer so that I'm able to see one state at a time here and I don't have to look at them all at the same time. I want to make my dashboard more interactive. So let's see how we would go about inserting a slicer. Go back here to All Sales Final and go up to the Insert menu and go over here to Slicer. Next, I am asked, how do I want to slice, or in what ways do I want to look at my data? Again, I'm going to pick the state because that is how I want to be able to tell the profit totals by state. Next, I'll click OK. Here now is my slicer. I'm going to right click on here and go to Cut. And then I'm going to go over to my dashboard and I'm going to right click here and select Paste. Now I can see my slicer on the main dashboard as well as my map. So now watch what happens. If I select just Pennsylvania, I'm now able to zoom into the state of just Pennsylvania. If I select New York, I can see New York, New Jersey, and Maryland. However, if I would like to select more than one state on this slicer, I can go up here to these multi-select options. So if I click on that, I can now select several states. And as you can see, every time I pick a state, my map is updating. I can also deselect that and go back to picking one state. This button up here allows me to clear all the filters I have and go back to my default view of the map of all of the states in the area. So let's clean this up a little bit. First of all, I'm going to put a label over here that says Select State so that the user knows that this is a selectable box. Also, I would like to change the title on my chart. I'm going to double click in here and say Profits by State. And then finally, I can just move my map over here. If I hold my mouse here until it looks like a diagonal, I can just hold my left mouse button down and drag to the right. And now my map is bigger and my user can go and select different states or remove the filter. So that's how to create a map on a dashboard when you're dealing with geographical information. Next week, we are going to cover putting in some graphs and some additional slicers. And also down here, if you look, we can put in some trend lines. These are called spark lines, and they give you a quick view of how your data is trending. But we will cover that in our third and final video of our dashboard series. Hopefully you learned something new today. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.